What's up, guys? Welcome to a brand new episode of... I don't even know if this is Unranked Diamond anymore, if it's just, hey, welcome to a new gameplay. But hope you guys are having a great day, having a good December so far, I guess. I know I've been kind of AFK for a little bit. I've been moving house. You can see the new setup. This is actually a blind behind me, by the way. It's not a green screen or a black screen. It's actually just a blind because I've got a window behind me. I'm going to get a green screen put in there, though, because it looks a bit weird, I think. And I'm going to get a green screen and kind of, like, fade out the background. So, that's soon, TM. I'm going to order that. Oh, okay. Let's get this. Oh! Oh! Oh, now I go back and get my second. Okay, this, by the way, is, like, the most amazing thing, because if I get my, if I get this now, like, here, I get so much regen in the jungle, and it's such a better clear. Like, I know a lot of people would get some AD here, and they would just, like, I kind of scored like a little girl there, didn't I? They'd get some AD or something like that, but actually, if you get both of these, your clear speed is just insanely fast. It's really healthy. It's great. So, that's why I'm going to get that instead. And, yeah, we'll go from there. But, yeah, I'm sorry I've been AFK a little bit. I'm moving house, and I haven't had internet either, which has been a pain in the ass. So, I'm going to try to catch up on my main channel with some sponsor stuff and everything like that. Which has meant that I haven't really had time to do any gameplays or anything at the moment. But we should be back now, good and fine. Hopefully 100% back working. And I wanted to play I wanted to play jungle a bit more. I'm not enjoying AD anymore, really. Not much of you're going to be surprised by that, honestly. But I said this in a little bit in another video. The short of it is basically... AD has become less about you and more just about your team and, like, you know, do I get four man ganked? Does my jungler help me? Does their jungler camp me? Is my support good? And stuff like that, which is not really why I started playing AD in the first place anyway. So I'm actually just finding it a little bit less fun this season, and that's why I'm kind of getting a bit more salty on the channel and stuff, because I'm not really having fun when I'm playing. So I thought, okay, let's just play champions I actually want to play. Let's just have some fun with the game. And if I have fun with the game, chances are, you know, it's gonna show my videos, you guys are gonna have fun with me, and that's exactly what I want to do. I want to happen. So we're gonna play whatever I want to play, really, more than anything else. Play jungle a lot, probably, because I really enjoy it. I'll play some AD as well, especially when, like, Lucian gets buffed and stuff like that. But I'm gonna go with more, hopefully you guys still watch the videos and you still enjoy them, but I'm gonna go with more what I just want to play. So Nocturne's really good at the moment, I think. Personally, one of my, like, favorite junglers to play. I'm not going to use my... I probably should use my Q. Because, like, your mana regen is really good when you have this thing. This thing, yeah, is better mana regen. So, should... Oh, my God, my voice. Should be using my spells a bit more here. But, yeah, Nocturne is really good. His clear speed is really good. And also, he has lots of AoE with his passive and his Q. So, you don't have to really worry... Oh, wow, okay. Nice. You don't really have to worry about, like, your... running out of health or getting invaded or how fast you can farm, because honestly, like, now, for example, like, I don't really have anywhere to gank because everywhere is doing really well, so I'm just gonna power farm, and there's nothing wrong with that. Like, I know I have the second jungle item, so it's a little bit different, right? I'm not gonna be this healthy all of the time, but that's gonna be that. We're actually running Fervor Battle this game, though, which is... I'm gonna go for this. I think I'm probably gonna die here, but yeah, I should have turned immediately. Okay, fair enough. That's fine, that's fine. I should have turned immediately here. Nice, well played. That was really easy for LeBlanc, though. That was all planned. All planned for LeBlanc. All planned for LeBlanc. Part of what I'm going to be learning jungle a lot. And while I'm learning jungle, I'm going to make some mistakes like that. But I'm always going to, like, analyze them and explain why I'm doing it. So one of the reasons, like, you always trying to make... Well, you don't try and make mistakes, but you take risks, is because you learn more with risks. So, like, I learn how much damage I have, because if I had known that I could have won that, I could have immediately turned, right? Flashed on him, just and gone for him straight away. Oh, he marked me. Okay, what a dick. And I would have been able to do... Probably would have been able to win that fight, actually, if I turned him instantly. So this is why it's good, because now next time I know that, I'm learning their damage more and stuff, and in future games, it's going to be a lot easier, right? So, yeah, it's not too bad, but this is going to be Fervor with Thunderlords, actually. You know, I think I probably would have killed him, because I would have had the Thunderlords proc. I'm not 100% sure on that, but it, I think, would have had a good chance of probably picking him off there, which is also another thing. But I'm running Fervor because I'm going to go a different build. So I'm going to be going Bloodrazor. Don't think he's going to dive this. That's whenever there's a gank and stuff on the map, you always want to move to it just in case, right? It's that what if kind of thing. It's like, okay, what if, like, I actually end up needing it? What if LeBlanc, because LeBlanc could have got away there, so that's why I didn't go immediately. I was just like, well, she didn't need me, right? She didn't need me, but what if LeBlanc turns and then I manage to pick up a kill? So that's why you always move. Anyway, nocturne build. Normally, if you've watched me before, I go warrior into, like, I go full AD. Warrior, Yumus, Black Cleaver, stuff like that. I go like proper ham on the AD. But this time we're going to be going attack speed and we're going to be using Fervor. So Fervor with attack speed is really good because obviously you stack it really fast. For melee people, you only need 4 hits actually to stack it to full. So I only need to get 4 attacks off. If I'm going Bloodrazor into Blade of the Ring King, which is going to be the build this time, then that's a lot of attack speed. I stack my Fervor super fast. It buffs my Q damage. It buffs my auto damage even more, which is already insane. And in theory, I don't know why I'm actually, I wanted to do this, but yeah, I don't really have any way of getting in or anything. So I'm just watching. I heard the sound effects for her her E there, so I decided to go anyway. So yeah, that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go attack speed build. We absolutely destroy objectives with this attack speed build as well, which is great. Destroy objectives with the attack speed build, and we will be able to just like 1v1 people immensely. So, like, this Norse won't stand a chance, for example. Maybe I should have helped him with the thingy, but I don't know. I thought he would have had that with the Leona, and if I just took away... Kindred is level 6, don't really want to do that. Don't really want to do that, I don't think that's worth it. Don't think that's worth it. Let's just hope she doesn't try and do, or they. Kindred's technically a they, right? Because she has the ghost and she has, and she has the, like, her thing. But I can go back and get my Bloodrazor, so I should redo that soon. I just want to pick up my red buff so she doesn't steal it. Ideally, this actually isn't very good because I'm going to base now. I'm going to smite this. Ideally, this isn't very good because I'm actually going to waste some of the red duration. Red is a really good ganking tool for, like, any jungler, but if I go back now, I'm actually just wasting it, really. I'm not actually getting anything out of it, so that kind of sucks. Let's get this in a control ward, though, and I think we'll probably change this to a sweeper now as well. So let's go and get our blue buff for LeBlanc. I do want to get this... dragon though, because as I was saying, like, I'm gonna get Bloodrazor, which is max percentage health damage, Blade of Ring King, which is current health damage, and then I'm going to have like my Fervor stacking, so that's gonna be doing a lot of damage. But also, oh, he's gonna mark me again. Oh no, he removed his mark on me. Okay. Oh, that was a lot of damage. Oh, that boy. I know Nautilus is here, so I'm going to try and run here. Actually, Maokai's on him, so maybe I can go back in for this. I have to be a bit careful because... Okay. Katarina's probably still... Oh no, he went mid. What the hell? Thank you very much. Thank you for that. Well played. So I wanted to use my fear on the Katarina there. That's why I didn't use it straight away, because I thought Katarina was going to jump in. Okay, my fear is not really needed for the Kindred right now, but I probably should have used it in hindsight to save the LeBlanc. But my fear wasn't really needed for me to pick up the kill. I knew he was dead anyway. So I was like, okay, well... Probably shouldn't have done that. That was a bit of a dick move. Whoops. Didn't realize you were back already. Yeah, so I didn't really need it. So I was like, okay, if Katarina dives in and she uses her ultimate, the only thing I have to interrupt it is to use my E. And that's like the biggest way you beat Kat, is just by having her E interrupted. So I kind of needed it for that, but then Kat didn't go in, so it ended up being a waste. But that's the only thing I probably could have improved on in that fight, maybe. Not entirely sure. But yeah, as I was saying, so I'm going to have the percentage health damage from Bloodrazor, percentage health damage from the... I'm going to go for this, I think. I'm just absorbed his thing here. I'm gonna try and stand in front of him. Oh, bollocks. Okay. I tried to stand in front of him here because... Oh, Kindred's right here. Okay. I'm gonna use my spell shield to try and block the lamb thingy. I don't even know if that works or not, but I'm gonna do it anyway just to try it. Nice, there we go. So I'm really, really strong with this Bloodrazor, and I absolutely ripped through tanks. On a warrior Nocturne, I probably wouldn't have actually gone for that, because honestly, like, I don't have the burst damage to kill Nocturne. When you go warrior and you go Thunderlords, you're all about burst on the build. With this build, you're all about sustained damage, and you're about, like, trying to rip through people as much as possible. Trying to rip through people over a period of time. This is what I was saying about the Earthdrake, Mountain Drake before I got distracted. It was like, you have the percentage damage from Bloodrazor, from Borks, so both of them are really good at objectives. And then you have the Mountain Drake on top, which does true damage to objectives. And suddenly you are just like the ultimate Baron or Dragon Killer. And that means I can sneak, like, me and Maokai can duo Baron, for example. Like, the plan with this build is not only be an ultimate tank killer and ultimate everything killer, it's just to be an objective control machine. And, like, yeah, I will easily be able to take these objectives by myself, but I don't really want to do it, like, while I'm on my own and there's no bot lane, for example, and, like, mid's being pushed out a little bit. So spell shield again to see if I can. Nice. Might as well. Now that should be dragon, which is perfect for us. Okay. Cool. This is the power of Nocturne, though. Even with a Bloodrazor build, which in theory should be that kind of build that takes longer to come online in the game. Like, this is a late game build, really, for Nocturne. If I wanted early pressure, I would have gone for warrior. But I actually don't have smite now because I used it on thingy, but... This literally just came off cooldown, by the way. Like, literally just a second ago, it came off cooldown. And we're gonna get another couple of kills with it. Nice, nice. This is how you snowball a game, though. Every time your ultimate's off cooldown, you just use it. That was really kind of lucky and awesome at the same time, though. But yeah, so Nocturne is basically... like, he is an early game machine. He's so good early because he does so much damage. He's like a Lee Sin level of damage. You have your spell shield built into your kit, which I also think is insane. And this, but this side is the late game build. Like, this is the one where you're supposed to just get, go late game, and you're supposed to destroy people, like, with your auto attacks and stuff, especially with Fervor. But apparently that just didn't happen this game because we got so far ahead anyway. And that's why I love Nocturne. He's like, Lee Sin, but long range. A bit more useful in team fights and stuff, and more useful late game. You can actually, like, solo carry a game. They're probably not going to see it this time because I think bot lane might have actually gone AFK. But honestly, this is still a good video to show you why Nocturne in this build is so strong. So, yeah, which is good. I actually didn't get carried for once. Who would have thought? Oh, I missed that. How did she drop a dagger on the floor there? She's a W. I still don't understand the new Katarina that well, honestly. She's like one of the champions who I'm actually, like, one of the few champions where I'm just not very comfortable playing against her because I don't really understand her properly yet. I'm pretty sure Maokai's gonna kill all of these, by the way. I'm gonna fear this guy because I can't get in range to fear Kindred, so. Don't have my ultimate yet, so I can't go on the Kindred. I went top, though, because I saw Kindred up there, so I was like, oh, that's the only place I can really help. She does not pay attention. I should have flashed on her and just killed her under tower, but... Yeah, I'm a bit of a pussy. Okay, let's go and get his red buff, which is spawning right now. Never mind, let's get the top tower, then. They're actually ending the game bot lane, though. They're actually ending the game bot lane. Well, this is a really good example of how you snowball a game, though. Because thankfully, we actually did a lot of the work, which is unusual. Because normally, right, when I have these kind of games in... When I have these kind of games where I'm like, it's just really snowbally and stuff, I don't upload them, actually. I just play again. But this time, this was actually us, which helped to do it. So this is actually a useful game to learn how to snowball as a jungler, so... Yeah, and it also shows off the build a little bit. Like how, I'm going to do this build again because I love Nocturne, I love this build at the moment. But it does show off Fervor, Nocturne... I really want to steal that with my key, honestly, but I'm not going to. I think I might have flashed on the spot there. I'm not sure. Who knows? Who knows? But anyway, that was a pretty ridiculous game. Like, I was scratching my nose so I couldn't. Thank you for the KDA. Yeah, I didn't get another kill for that. Did I? I thought I was on 11 kills already. I thought I was on 11 kills already. Who knows? Anyway, that was a pretty good game. I know it was a bit of a stomp, but we'll go into obviously like mid game and stuff. But like early game is where junglers actually shine the most. As an AD carry, actually no, even as an AD carry that would have been okay to show, I think, because you S plus, the S plus dream. Okay, nice. So we actually had the most gold in the game. We had decent farm, and that's part of it as well, is because a new jungle is ideal if you can farm it. You can have so much gold generation. So the thing you really want is you want to have farm and you want to have ganking potential, which is what Nocturne does both of. So that's really one of the reasons this build works insanely well. I actually even did more damage than LeBlanc this game. Just kind of ridiculous. But yeah, hopefully you guys can learn something from this. I tried to be way more educational with the build stuff and with like what I'm doing and everything like that. So hopefully this is like the fresh start of the channel where I'm going to be back to educational bit and like fun, entertaining and stuff again. So hopefully you guys really enjoy this video. Let me know what you think in the comments and I'll catch you in tomorrow's episode.